Good morning, students of class 4. Today I am here to continue the lesson with you, Tine and the Faraway Mountain. So now let us go to the next page in your lesson and see what happens next. So today is the 15th and let us open to the next page. It was divided into 4 sections so that the climbers could take rest at different camping points while journeying to the top of the mountain. By the time Tine and her companion Charing Shepra reached the second camp, the weather had grown worse. "Do you want to go ahead?" Charing asked. "I don't think I will get another chance to do this," Tine replied. She could hear the musical wushu growing louder and louder. It almost hypnotized her. Tine and Charing somehow managed to reach their final camp. Just as they were about to take rest, the stormy wind blew their tent and supplies away. So what happened, students, now? That it was divided into 4 sections, okay? So that the climbers could take rest at different camping points while going up the mountain. Okay, it was divided into 4 sections. And by the time Tine and her companion Charing reached the second camp, the weather was very bad. The weather grew worse. Worst meaning? The weather was bad. Okay. "Do you want to go ahead?" her friend asked. Okay. "Do you want to go ahead?" Then what did she say? What did Tine say? "I don't think I will get another chance to do this." She said that she will not get another chance to do this. She could hear the musical wushu, that sound, okay, that is growing louder and louder. And that hypnotized her. Hypnotized her meaning? Affected her like a magical spell. Okay, she was mesmerized by it. She was hypnotized by it. It affected her like a magic spell. Tine and Charing somehow managed to reach their final camp. And then slowly but surely they reached the final camp. Just as they were about to take some rest. Okay, as they reached the final camp, they were about to take some rest. Then what happened? A stormy wind blew their tent and supplies away. A very strong wind, a very stormy wind blew what? Blew their tent and their supplies away. What is the meaning of supplies, students? Supplies means things like food, torches, first aid kits and so on that is carried by mountaineers to help them survive on their journey. Okay, so that is supplies. So the wind, stormy wind, blew their tent and supplies away. Now let us see what happens next. They had to spend the night in one borrowed tent. And when they set off for the final climb the next day, all Tine and Charing had was a packet of noodles. "Let's share half of it," Charing suggested. Tine nodded her head, smiling determinately. "If we make it alive, we will eat the other half." Okay, so what happened? They spent the night in a borrowed tent. Okay, and when they set off for their final climb the next day, they only ate a packet of noodles. And her friend suggested that let us share the noodles. Then what did Tine say? Tine nodded her head and smiled in a very determined manner, meaning in a manner that she was very confident that she was going to make it alive. And when we make it alive, we will eat the other half. What is the meaning of make it alive? Make it alive means manage to finish the climb and return back alive. So she was determined that she will finish the climb. And she will make it back alive. And when they come back, they will eat the other half. The higher they climbed, the stronger the wind grew. For every two steps they took, it sent them reeling back a step. It shrieked and howled, whispering dread into their ears and surging them to return. Sorry, and urging them to return. Okay? But Tine could not hear the magical tune of Wushu. So, they pushed ahead fearlessly and continued to climb to the top. So, what happened? The higher they were climbing, the stronger the wind was becoming. For every two steps they took, it sent them reeling back a step. Now, what is reeling back a step? Meaning, moving backwards. Okay, in an unsteady manner. Reeling back means moving backwards in an unsteady manner. It shrieked and howled, whispering dread into their ears. Okay, what is the meaning of dread? Dread meaning great fear, you know, and uncertainty about what is going to happen. So, as they were climbing up, they were getting very scared. Okay. You know, they were having fear and urging them to return. Urging meaning trying to persuade or make someone do something. So, what was the urge? Urging them to return. Okay, that don't climb any further, let it be, it is too dangerous. That was the fear that was coming to them. But did Tine let this fear take over her? No, she did not. Tine could hear again the magical tune of Wushu, you know. So she pushed ahead, so she went ahead fearlessly and she continued to climb to the top. Okay. Now let's see what happens next. Finally, at 10:45 a.m. on 9 May 2011, Tine's efforts were rewarded. She summited Mount Everest, the highest mountain in the world. The first woman from the northeast of India to have done so. She had found her faraway mountain and was one with the sound that had called her all her life. So students, finally at 10:45 a.m. on the 9th May 2011, her efforts were rewarded. Why? Because she submitted Mount Everest. Submitted meaning? What is the meaning of submitted? It means that she climbed to the top of the mountain. She climbed to the top. She reached to the top. Mount Everest, the highest mountain in the world she has reached. And she was the first woman from the northeast of India to have done this. Okay. She found her faraway mountain, her dream to climb the Mount Everest. She has succeeded in fulfilling her dream. And the sound that she always heard all her life. Okay. And was one with the sound. She was one now with the sound that she heard all her life. And she succeeded in climbing the Mount Everest. So students, I hope the lesson is nice and clear to you. Let us go to the word meanings of today. Some difficult word meanings are given to you. You have to write them in your English literature copy. You will learn the word meanings well. Number one, hypnotized, meaning affected her like a magic spell. Number two, supplies. Things like food, torches, first aid kit and so on carried by mountaineers to help them survive on their journey. Then make it alive, meaning manage to finish the camp, manage to finish the climb and return alive. So make it alive is manage to finish the climb and return alive. Reeling back, moving backwards very unsteadily. Dread, great fear and uncertainty about what could happen. Urging, trying to persuade or make someone do something. Submitted, climb to the top of the mountain. Okay? This is all for today, students. Thank you. I hope the lesson is clear to you, students. Download the link below my video. You can read the entire PPT that I have taught you today. Read it at home. Learn the word meanings well. Write the word meanings in your English literature copy.
And in the next class, I will give you the question and answers. Thank you, students, and God bless you.